Hello friends, this is Shalupal. Welcome to my YouTube channel Learn by Watch Career. Today we will learn about group discussion skills. You might have heard about group discussion, or you might have given group discussion in any company or to apply for admission in any institutions. I just want to share with you one more thing, that group is a collection of individuals and discussion is the process whereby two or more people exchange information or ideas in a face-to-face situation to achieve a goal. So a group discussion is a group of individuals with similar interests who gather either formally or informally to bring up ideas, solve problems or give comments. So group discussion, in short GD, forms an important part of the shortlisting process for recruitment in a company or admission in an institution. So let's see, what is group discussion? Group discussion is a methodology used by an organization to gauge whether the candidate has certain personality traits and skills that it desires in its members. Organization may be a company, institute, or business school. In this methodology, a group of candidates is given a topic or a situation, typically given some time to think about the same, and then asked to discuss it among themselves for a specific duration. Every participant will share his or her views and opinions with other participants. It is a systematic exchange of information, views and opinions about a topic, problem, issue or situation among the members of a group. So let's see, what is the process of group discussion? We will see step by step. First is group. Group is selected by the company professionals or the selection committee. The process begins by the announcement of the topic to the group. So second is topic, which is usually followed by the preparation time of 3 to 5 minutes. This is time. More than 5 minutes preparation time may be given only if the GD is a case study discussion and has a long case statement. At the end of the preparation time, the panel signals the group to start the discussion. Panel will only play the role of non-participating observers. They will not be moderating or guiding the discussion. The group members must discuss the topic without any kind of suggestions from the panel. The average duration of most GDs is 15 minutes. In some exceptional cases, GD may continue for up to 45 minutes. One must remember that the longer the GD goes on, the more seriously the panel looks at the quality of the content of the participant. Any of the participants can initiate the GD by introducing about the topic in details, and then further discussion will be continued by other participants. All group members will be actively discuss about the topic on different aspects. The panel usually consists of 3 or more members who look at various aspects of the participant's content and delivery. Please remember that the panelist may end the GD whenever they want to and also extend the GD for as much as they want to. Nobody among the participants is supposed to keep time for the group or act on the assumption that the GD will end after the 15th minute. The GD ends in either of the two ways. First, the panel may abruptly stop the GD and announce the end of the process, and second, they may ask a participant to summarize the GD. So, the last step is what I call it as conclusion. If you are asked to summarize, do remember what summary means. Your summary cannot have anything in it that was not discussed during the GD. The summary must be an objective analysis of the important points brought up during the discussion and called as the conclusion of a discussion. So, I think you have understood about group discussion. Next is, why GD is conducted? Organizations conduct GDs to find out whether you possess the required skills to contribute effectively to their company. Group discussions are held because business management is essentially a group activity, and working with groups is the most important parameter of being successful as a manager. Apart from that, candidates are evaluated on the basis of their personality traits and group skills. You can see the list of skills judged by the panelist. Our first is communication skills, to check how good you are at communication with others. Second is interpersonal skills, to check how you behave and interact with the group. Third is leadership skills, to check your ability to work as a leader. Fourth is cooperation skills, to check whether you are cooperative or not. Fifth is team building skills, to check how you work and perform in a team. Sixth is listening skills, to check you are active listener or not. Seventh is problem solving skills to check how good you are in solving different problems. Eighth is decision making skills to check whether you are good in decision making or not and how you put forward your views in front of group. Ninth is analytical skills, or we can also call it as logical skills, to check how you analyze the situation and speak something which is relevant rather than blabbering without making any point, and try to conclude the group discussion with some important points. Tenth is subject knowledge. In a group discussion, panelists see how well you are aware of things, events happening or taking place around you. So you should read a lot and gain significant knowledge on various topics related to commerce, politics, nature, art, law and media and social causes, so that speaking up in the discussion come naturally to you. Providing facts and figures in numbers give you an added advantage over other candidates in a group discussion. Then it comes to attitude and confidence. Be smart and pleasant. Your confidence during a GD can get you in the good books of the panelist. Carry positive attitude with you throughout the GD. So these are all the skills which are judged when you are giving any GD. So now let's see what are the types of group discussion. Basically, there are two types of group discussion. You can refer this image. First is topic-based GD and second is case-based GD. In topic-based GDs, the group members are given a topic to discuss. A topic is typically in the form of statement. By the end of the discussion, the group should arrive at the conclusion on the issue that is covered by the topic. Further, topic-based GDs are classified into three subtypes: factual, controversial and abstract. Factual topics are about practical things which an ordinary person is aware of in his day-to-day life. Typically, these are about socio-economic topics. A factual topic or discussion gives a candidate a chance to prove that he is aware of and sensitive to his environment. Some examples are like the education policy of India, tourism in India, global warming. And controversial topics are the ones that you can argument a lot. They are made to generate controversy. In GDs, where these topics are given for discussion, the noise level is usually high. The idea behind giving a topic like this is to see how much maturity the candidate is displaying by keeping his temper in control, by pleasantly arguing his point of view and without getting personal and emotional. Some examples are women empowerment, crime in India, caste reservations should be removed and many more. Next is abstract topics. They are about intangible things. These topics are not given often for discussion, but their possibility cannot be ruled out. These topics test our critical thinking and creativity. Some examples are smart work versus hard work. There is no right way to do a wrong thing. Good things comes from good thinking. So now we will see second type of GD, which is case-based GD. In this type of GD, they will use a case instead of a topic. In case studies, a short description of a situation called a case is given to all the participants. The case will typically be a problem situation that requires a solution. The participants have to study the case, analyze the problem, and then discuss various situations to the problem. The case study tries to stimulate a real-life situation. The objective in the case study is to get you think about the situation from various angles. I am Ahmedabad, I am Indore, and IIT SOM Mumbai have a case-based discussion rather than topic-based discussion in their selection procedures. Many companies and institutes are making group discussion as the first criteria for screening the candidates for face-to-face interviews, as there is reason too for giving huge importance for group discussion. First thing, group discussion is used for mass elimination, and second thing is group discussion selection criteria are based on actual company requirements. Now let's see do's and don'ts of group discussion. First we will see do's of group discussion. First is you should dress formally while going to GD, as your dressing sense will describe about your personality. So dress well and take good care of your hygiene. Do not take it casually. No fancy and funny dressing. You should be comfortable while speaking in group. Second is always try to initiate the GD if you are aware of the given topic, because it will be definitely your first and good impression in the GD. Third is to maintain positive attitude and body language. Sit straight and have good facial expressions. Try to be in perfect body postures and use hand gestures while communicating. Fourth is to maintain good eye contact with every team member throughout the GD and especially while speaking. Fifth is to speak pleasantly and politely while sharing your views, ideas or any information. Use simple and understandable words while speaking. Sixth is to allow others to speak. It is very important thing to look cooperative and kind during GD. Seventh is to stay with the topic during the discussion. It is very important to avoid waste of time consumed in discussing irrelevant topics and also gives bad impression about you. If by any means group is distracting from the topic, then simply take initiative to bring the discussion back on track. Make all group members aware that you all need to come to some conclusion at the end of the discussion, so stick to the topic. Eighth is to be a good listener, because the panelists also observe your listening skills. So actively listen others' point of view during the discussion and respond accordingly. If you are less aware about the topic, then speak less and listen more. Pay attention while others are speaking. This will make coherent discussion and you will get involved in the group positively. You will surely make people agree with you. Ninth is to respect others' opinion, because it shows that you are open-minded. Tenth is to agree and acknowledge what you find interesting while discussion, because it shows your good interpersonal skills. Next, we will see don'ts of group discussion. First is, don't lose your temper while speaking, because it shows your inability to work in a team. Second is, don't argue with others. It shows that you are narrow-minded and don't respect others' opinion. Third is, don't shout. Always use soft and medium tone while speaking. Fourth is, don't use aggressive gestures, because it shows your bad body language and you will look arrogant. Don't be too aggressive if you are disagreeing with someone. Express your feelings calmly and politely. Fifth is, don't dominate the discussion. Do not try to dominate anyone. It will give a bad impression. Show interest in discussion. Sixth is, don't interrupt the speaker. Do not interrupt anyone in between while speaking. Even if you don't agree with his or her thoughts, do not snatch their chance to speak. Instead of this, make some notes and clear the points when it's your turn. Seventh is to avoid speaking more and irrelevant, because it shows your less concentration and nervousness. Stick to the topic and try to reach a conclusion. Eighth is, don't be silent, express your views. Do not speak just to increase your speaking time. Don't worry even if you speak less. Your thoughts should be sensible and relevant instead of irrelevant speech. Ninth is, don't be nervous, be confident. Show your confidence to face the GD. Go with the flow and try to showcase your skills as many as possible. Last and the most important point is, don't lie and avoid misguiding others. If you are unaware of the topic, avoid speaking more. Just listen to others and only agree to those points you find right for that topic. So, it's all about group discussion skills from my side. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel Learn by Watch Career for watching my more videos. Thank you.